Hi, I'm Noah, and welcome to A Kitchen. Whether it's my kitchen or not, you'll just have to find out. Today, we'll be cooking plastic. For this recipe, you will need kitchen tin snips, a kitchen hammer, another kitchen hammer, kitchen safety glasses, kitchen blender, and a kitchen box of 3D printed scraps. Let's get started. The first step should be to open up my box of 3D printed scraps. Now, I have yet to find anywhere in this city that is willing to just easily recycle these scraps. Today I decided that I'm going to take matters into my own hands and recycle them myself. In my own sort of creative way. So we're going to start by breaking up all the smaller pieces and putting them into our blender here. So now you might be wondering how you make your PLA smoothie nice and consistent, and yeah, I'm wondering that too. So I'm just going to put my lid on my blender thing here and put my glasses on, you know, safety third and all that. That's working quite well, but we might need to do a few more batches of that as this isn't quite enough PLA for a delicious meal. And now we stuff it filled with more PLA and give it another go until we've filled up this box with some lovely little bits of plastic. All right, so now that you've done a couple of rounds of blending, you've got a nice pot here of essentially filament dust. This lovely PLA here should melt quite nicely in the oven at around about 200 to 250 degrees Celsius. So let's just go and preheat that there now. Bake. Oh shoot. What's the conversion rate? All right, so we're looking for about 200 to 220 degrees Celsius, but because we live in a country which apparently cannot figure out what units to use, we're going to be putting in our oven in Fahrenheit while our thing melts at Celsius. God damn it, Canada, can you just pick a unit and stick with it? So I've got some lovely aluminum foil here to just line my pan with. And I'm going to line this pan nicely so I don't get any plastic in the pan itself. And that should allow the plastic to have a nice surface to melt in that I can easily peel away when we're done. And then we can do something nice and useful with this lovely plastic sheet. So now that you've lined your baking sheet, you're just going to take your plastic and just kind of pour it in there. So we're going to try and make it nice and even, knowing that it is going to reduce down in cooking. Most baked goods rise when they're cooking. However, due to the air escaping from the infill on the plastic, this is actually going to shrink. So you have to bear in mind to put a higher level of plastic in here than you want in your finished product. So this is what I've got here before I put it in the oven. You can see it is somewhat mixed, but hopefully it should be a fairly nice marbled texture when it comes out the oven, making for a lovely, appealing looking bake. Before I pop this in the oven, I just want to mention that I'm using a biodegradable filament. So it is a bioplastic and it is biodegradable, which means that I have to worry a little bit less about microplastics being polluted into the environment. So I'm going to pop this in the oven and make sure I dispose of all these extra little bits of plastic into the garbage. And I'm going to make sure I dispose of all these extra little bits of plastic into the garbage bin and make sure they do not work their way into the water supply, because the fish and all that, they're kind of nice. Also, just in case, to ensure that I don't get fumes all over me, I'm going to be turning my hood fan on, as the oven vent is back here and it should go directly up the hood fan, and I shouldn't be breathing in plastic fumes. So let's just pop this in and we'll check on it when it's done. And we're back. It's been about 15-20 minutes, so I'm just going to take the plastic out of the oven and let it cool down. And here we are, nice and cooled. Now, this really is a kind of bake that will really impress your friends when they see it. Now, take a look here. Look at that beautiful marbled effect on the top there. You really cannot get this any other way. And it truly is a sight to behold. So now that we've got this sheet, let's just remove the tin foil and then we can use it for something. Alright, so now we've got the tinfoil removed. As you can see, it's okay if you still have a couple little bits of tinfoil on here. It does stick quite badly sometimes. So now for what I'm gonna do with this lovely sheet here. For starters, it's very strong. What I wanna do though, is I wanna make a paper airplane. Well, I wanna make a PLA-ne. And here we have it, a finished PLA-ne. Beautiful, huh? It's got this lovely marbling effect on the top. Nice and strong. That is not a sound effect, by the way. That's what it actually sounds like. I have to say I'm surprised at how well this thing turned out. I mean, it's not good, but it's pretty neat. So let's give this thing a test flight, shall we? All right, so here we are on the deck. I've got the PLA-ne in my hand, and let's give it a flight and see how well it flies, shall we? But hey, the durability is off the charts. I mean, that's two crashes and it's fine. All right, so the aerodynamics of this might be awful, but on the upside, the durability of it is unparalleled. I mean, how many crashes was that and not even a scratch? All right, back to you, Indoranawa. Alright, so welcome to the fairly serious bit of the video. Yeah, I know that wasn't great. Aerodynamics, horrible. Everything else, horrible. Completely useless piece of junk. But the point of this is just kind of to show that this stuff's recyclable. It's really easy, you can make it into something else at your home. And while I might not have done a fairly good job at that, someone with much more equipment who could start up an actual recycling company could really make a difference in this. The fact that I can't find anywhere to recycle all of this stuff in a fairly large city is kind of an issue. And really, as a society, we need to find a way to make recycling work better so we don't have to be melting our scraps together in our basements. Anyways, that's the end of the video. If you want to see more stuff like this, maybe subscribe or something. I don't know, hit the like button if you liked it, hit the dislike button if you didn't like it. Have a great day, and thank you so much for watching.